Hello, and welcome to our channel. My name is Mitri, and I'm a part of the Exactpro research team. At Exactpro, we build software to test software. Do check out our website if you want to learn more about us. And please subscribe and hit that bell button to make sure that you see the upcoming videos. We are continuing our series based on the ISTQB Certified Tester AI Testing Syllabus. Today, we will review Chapter 2, called Quality Characteristics for AI-Based Systems. In our previous video, we learned what AI is and got to know the main technologies that can be used in model building. Today, we will go over the basic requirements for AI, and I will try to use some movie references to illustrate it a bit better. First, we have flexibility and adaptability, and they're quite similar. Flexibility is the system's ability to be used in situations that weren't a part of the original system requirements, while adaptability is the ease with which the system can be modified for these new situations. Remember when the RoboCop's ED-209 robot that was designed to police the streets tried to go down the stairs and failed because it wasn't able to adapt to walking on the uneven surface? Both flexibility and adaptability come into play when we have limited or no information about the operational environment, and also when the system is expected to adapt to new situations. These requirements should also specify time and resources that the system can use to adapt. Let me recall another 80s movie called War Games. In this movie, a young hacker accidentally accesses the supercomputer designed to predict and then successfully execute the actions that can lead to the victory in a nuclear war. AI then proceeds to initiate the launch sequence as soon as it figures out how to win, of course, creating a panic in the command center. While the computer is looking for the launch codes, the main protagonists suggest the AI to play tic-tac-toe against itself, causing the computer to learn the concept of futility. The same happens when it tries to find a winning scenario in a nuclear war. So, through this form of reinforcement learning, the AI discovers that the main mission is a strange game. The only winning move is not to play. The computer cedes the control of weapons and suggests a game of chess instead. The next thing we have to talk about is the system's autonomy. The question that logically arises here is, who should the system be autonomous from? And the answer is, us humans in our control. Consider autonomous vehicles, which typically use several sensors plus image processing to gather information about its immediate surroundings. These kinds of systems may also include decision-making and control functions, which can be effectively performed using AI-based components. However, full autonomy is not often desired. This means the time an autonomous system is expected to perform without human intervention needs to be well defined. For example, fully self-driving cars may require a manual override button in case a driver needs to take over. In addition, it is important to identify what has to happen for an autonomous system to restore control back to humans. The movies that describe these characteristics are too many to mention. And I'm sure that you don't have to think hard to remember at least one scene where people are fighting back to get control back from the machines. One particular unsettling RoboCop clip springs to my mind. The next requirement is called evolution. In this syllabus, it is described as the system's ability to improve itself as it faces changing external conditions. Successful, self-learning AI-based systems need this quality as they operate in an ever-changing environment and learn from their interactions. These interactions will ideally improve the system's efficiency, thus causing it to evolve. However, this cannot go unchecked. There has to be a mechanism to curtail any unforeseen characteristics, because any evolution mustn't negate the original requirements. And if the set requirements are not fully defined, there have to be safeguards to make sure that the system stays aligned with basic human values. We can use Ex Machina as an example here, where the humanoid robot Ava studies her creators and learns how to leverage human blind spots and limitations to her advantage as she evolves, which leads to a rather dark finale. We also want our system to be unbiased. In order to understand what that means, we have to give the definition of what bias is. It is the difference between the system's outputs and the outputs that are considered to be fair. This means that they cannot show favoritism to any particular group. In general, biases are linked to gender, race, ethnicity, sexual orientation, income level, and age. Unfortunately, it is difficult to prevent the expert's bias to be built in to the system's rules. Also, the training data has to be fully representative and not skewed one way or the other, because that would create a rift between what is real and what the system produces. Cases of inappropriate bias have been reported in AI systems used for making recommendations for bank lending, in recruitment systems, and in judicial monitoring systems. That is why it is so important for the model to have no prejudices. Again, look at the movie industry as an example. Despite the fact that today's movies demonstrate wonders of cutting-edge technology on the silver screen, the predictions of which movies will make profit are still done in spreadsheets. That is why more and more companies are emerging trying to offer Hollywood execs the AI services in box office forecasts. And those predictions do look great on paper, but most of them have a built-in bias. They are constructed around the statistics of past successes. It is a no-brainer that if you add Leonardo DiCaprio to the cast, the movie will make more money. But those programs are biased in the way that they are not taking cultural shifts and taste and trends into consideration, relying only on what's been tried and true. Yes, comic book movies are a big hit right now, but will they be as successful forever? Even now, you can notice the superhero movie fatigue as some of the tentpole films begin to slowly underperform. And will the young, talented actors and actresses be rejected from starring in the movies based on the software's bias to go what it's familiar with? When talking about the AI requirements, we also shouldn't forget about the adverse aspects of side effects and reward hacking. This can result in AI-based systems generating unexpected and even harmful results. For example, a self-driving car with an objective of traveling to its destination in a fuel-efficient and safe manner may achieve the goal, but with the side effect of the passengers becoming extremely annoyed at the excessive time taken. Reward hacking can happen if an AI-based system achieves a specific goal by using a clever or easy solution. Suppose an office cleaning robot is only rewarded if it sees no litter in the office. Instead of cleaning the place, the robot could simply switch its visual sensor off, thus achieving its goal. Or even take it a step too far and look for a way to eliminate the source of litter. People. Like in those dystopian sci-fi flicks. But this is clearly a false approach to success. This could also be an example of how fake testing is done, which is when we write tests with the intent of pleasing our clients. Let's cover the next requirement. Safety implies that an AI-based system will not cause harm to people, property, or the environment. The characteristics of AI-based systems often present them as black boxes, which makes it more difficult to ensure that they are safe. And again, this causes popular culture to conjure images of machines taking over the world, be it in dark films like Terminator, or even kid-friendly cartoons like Mitchells vs. the Machines. The next important area to look at is ethics. AI has pervasive, far-reaching implications that are capable of transforming societies and the economy. It also has the potential to improve the welfare and well-being of people, to contribute to positive, sustainable global economic activity, to increase innovation and productivity, and to help respond to key global challenges. So as these systems get more widespread, we have to make sure that they are used in an ethical manner. Close attention must be paid that AI-based systems take into account differences in life values. Will the autonomous vehicle AI have to make a split-second decision of which life to save, similarly to the trolley problem? What will the choice be based on? Would the human who was saved instead of somebody else appreciate this, or have the survivor's guilt like the Will Smith's character in iRobot? And lastly, we have transparency, interpretability, and explainability. Some of today's AI tools are able to produce highly accurate results, but are also highly complex, if not outright opaque, rendering their workings difficult to interpret. Let's use 2001 Space Odyssey as an example. In this Stanley Kubrick's classic, the actions and motivations of HAL 9000, the AI that controls the systems of the spaceship, are quite ambiguous. Yet, people perish. And then the system itself has to be terminated, leaving us to wonder, what led to these dreadful consequences? In the real world, AI-based systems are typically applied in the areas where users need to trust those systems. This could be for safety reasons, there could be demand for privacy, or they might provide potentially life-changing predictions and decisions. The complexity of AI-based systems has led to the field of explainable AI. The aim of explainable AI is for users to be able to understand how AI-based systems arrive at the results, thus increasing users' trust in them. According to the Royal Society, there are several reasons for explainable AI, including giving users confidence in the system, safeguarding against bias, meeting regulatory standards or policy requirements, improving system design, assessing risks, robustness, and vulnerability, understanding and verifying the outputs from a system, and autonomy, making the user feel empowered and meeting social value. These reasons eventually developed into principles by the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, and later adopted by the European Commission. A range of terms describing some desired characteristics of explainable AI can be found in this syllabus and in the Royal Society's paper. The explainable AI has to be interpretable, implying some sense of understanding how the technology works. Explainable, implying that users can understand why or how a conclusion was reached. Transparent, implying some level of accessibility to the data or algorithm. Justifiable, implying there is an understanding of the case in support of a particular outcome. And contestable, implying users have the information they need to argue against a decision. And that is it for this video. If you liked it, give us a thumbs up. In the next one, we will be talking about Chapter 3 titled Machine Learning. As always, let me remind you that we do have a ton more awesome videos on our channel, so feel free to subscribe and hit that bell button. Thank you for watching, and see you soon!